Do you want more confidence? The ability to walk into a new situation and know that you can handle it, the ability to speak up and stand up for yourself when you need to, and the ability to know that you're okay even if someone doesn't like you or judges you. Those are just a few of the changes in our life when we become more confident. And if you're watching this channel, you probably want to become more confident. I'm Dr. Aziz. I've been studying confidence for over 18 years, and here's the thing. There's one really simple tip I want to share today that's going to sound so simple that you're going to think, like, nah, I don't know if that can work. But trust me, this simple thing that you can do can radically increase your confidence way more than elaborate techniques or therapy tools or psychological or even actions that you could take. Do you want to know what it is? Okay, here we go. If you want to become significantly more confident in your life, you must do this. Decide right now, as you're watching this video, just decide, I am going to be more confident. I told you it was going to sound kind of stupid simple, but after studying this for so long, I realized that kind of the simple stuff done consistently, makes the hugest difference, right? I mean, that's why I have a book called On My Own Side, and it's about how to talk to yourself differently. And if you consistently talk to yourself differently, you don't berate yourself, criticize yourself, judge yourself, tell yourself that you suck all the time. Surprisingly, our confidence goes up, right? So it's not complicated, but it's about repetition of simple things again and again and again. Same thing with fitness. Same thing with success in business. It's the simple things done repeatedly and done well. So what is this decision to be more confident? Really what it is right now, can you just feel inside of yourself? Can you get a sense of how you relate to life? How you treat yourself, how you focus on what other people are going to think, and just decide, you know what? I'm going to do something different. In fact, maybe just say that out loud with me right now. Say, you know what? I'm going to do something different. Now, if you just watched me, I'm going to invite you again. Say it out loud. I am going to do something different. That matters. When you say it out loud, it's a proclamation. It affects your subconscious. It affects you. You start to change. You start to align with that new statement that you just made. We want to live into our statements. We want to be congruent. We don't want to be a hypocrite. So if we say I'm going to do something, we want to follow through. Part of us wants to follow through. So I'm going to do something different. I'm going to decide to be more confident. Now what you do is that's going to give you some boost, some shift, some slight degree change in your experience. So then what happens? Later that day, or maybe even right now, there's something you're facing. You got this meeting coming up. You got to go have this conversation with someone. You are interested in somebody. You want to ask them out, whatever it is. And you notice that that anxiety, that stress, that concern, that worry start to arise. And you say, you know what? I'm going to do this different. I'm going to approach this with more confidence. Now, does that solve all your problems? Are you instantly more confident? Not necessarily. But you know what the shift has been? All of a sudden now, you're going to start doing something different. You're not going to run that same old pattern of like, oh my gosh, the meeting's coming up. And then just, what do you normally do? Oh, I judge myself. I tell myself I didn't prepare enough. It's not going to go well. I'm not smart enough, blah, blah, blah. And you say, you know what? I'm doing something different now. I've decided that I'm going to be confident. So what am I going to do? Well, I don't know. Now I'm going to figure it out. Maybe I need to talk to myself differently. Maybe I need to, instead of focusing on me and how they're going to think about me, maybe I need to focus on the content I'm going to share. Maybe I need to focus on what's the point of this meeting? What am I trying to get across? Now, all of a sudden, you're not so focused on me and am I good enough in your ego? You're focused on what's the point? Why are we all here? Why do we have this meeting in the first place? What's the result that we're going for? And I could list 100 other ways that you could shift your focus, your actions, your self-talk, your belief, all that stuff that I teach elsewhere. But do you see how it all stems from that decision? And of course, if you want more tools on like, okay, I've decided, now what do I do? Start with my ebook if you haven't already got that. It's my gift to you. It's complimentary. If you go to draziz.com, draziz.com, you can enter your email and get my ebook. It's called 5 Steps to Unleash Your Inner Confidence. And those will give you specific tools and strategies to do. So that's just, then there's so much more than that you can find on this channel and elsewhere, but it's going to start with that decision. So share down below, what are you learning? What decision are you making? How is it affecting your confidence? And if you like this stuff and you want more, you want to stay current with all the videos I do, then hit subscribe down below and make sure you turn on the bell for notifications so you can watch these videos as soon as they come out. Because the more you study this stuff, the more you immerse yourself, the faster you're going to grow in your confidence. And remember this, Confidence is a muscle. So you make that decision, and then you practice those small steps again and again. The simple stuff over time produces powerful transformation. Awesome. Thanks for being with me today. Until we speak again, may you have the courage to be who you are and to know on a deep level that you're awesome.